Continuing our coverage of Stargirl, we want to discuss the other half of the heroic duo today. Pat Dugan is a Golden Age sidekick that grew up to be a modern age sidekick. Going by the codename Stripe, or Special Tactics Robotic Integrated Power Enhancer, today's video is going to cover the origins and abilities of Pat Dugan. Pat Dugan's comic book origins started far before the hero he is most closely associated with today. His first appearance was Star Spangled Comics number 1, where he's pretty much portrayed as a lovable oaf. Pat Dugan is the sidekick and chauffeur for Sylvester Pemberton, aka the Star Spangled Kid. When acting as a costumed hero, his superhero name is Stripesy, which definitely doesn't really age well. In his early appearances, Stripesy is shown to essentially be the comic book relief for Star Spangled Kid. He gets his underwear caught on nails, falls flat on his face, and generally acts a bit like a goofball. However, despite the character's silliness, he's also quite bright, creating a ton of gadgets and being a whiz with cars, even creating the Star Rocket Racer, a flying car that acts as their main method of transportation. It's almost like we're foreshadowing for the future. Anyway, Stripesy also functions as kind of a strongman, but he doesn't really have any superpowers. He's just a regular guy, but he is exceptional at hand-to-hand combat and seems to be pretty strong, or at least exceptionally tough for the time period. Pat and Sylvester were active members of the Seven Soldiers of Victory, a 1940s team that also consisted of Shining Knight, Speedy, Green Arrow, Crimson Avenger, and Vigilante. However, not to confuse you, but the team was slightly different in the New Earth version of the Seven Soldiers of Victory, and that's actually the version of the team that we're going to be discussing next, because this team is a bit more relevant to the Stargirl character and her history. In this universe of the DC Prime Earth, the fall of the Seven Soldiers was told in Stars and Stripe number 9. This team consisted of Star Spangled Kid, Stripesy, Vigilante, the Shining Knight, Crimson Avenger, his sidekick Wing, and a character named Spider. During an adventure, the Seven Soldiers faced off against an extremely powerful enemy named Nebula Man, a being summoned from the Hand from the future using a device called the Sonic Horn. Nebula Man feeds off cosmic energy and is able to absorb it. The Hand points Nebula Man towards the Seven Soldiers of Victory, and they have a massive battle. Crimson Avenger attempts to stop Nebula Man using an object called the Nebula Rod, but after a massive explosion, along with the rest of the team, they are instead teleported halfway around the world to Tibet. Crimson Avenger's sidekick arrives to inform the team that they had actually been double-crossed by fellow teammate Spider working for the Hand. Spider removed a piece of the Nebula Rod, causing it to malfunction. Spider was then defeated by team member Wing, and Wing returns the piece to the Nebula Rod. Wing then sacrifices himself by attacking Nebula Man with the Nebula Rod. He dies in the attack, but it is much more powerful and has a remarkable side effect. It scattered the Seven Soldiers of Victory across time. Stripesy landed in ancient Egypt, and you're probably thinking, oh, that's pretty cool, he got to see the pyramids and everything, and yeah, of course he did, because he was immediately enslaved and forced to work on them. Future members of the JSA, Hourman, Batman, and Starman attempted a rescue operation, but were also imprisoned when they tried to face an entire army of Egyptians by themselves. While imprisoned, they were aided by an Egyptian prince named Khufu, and they created civil unrest and a revolution. Seeing as revolutions typically tend to be a large distraction, it was enough of one for them all to escape via a temporal portal Dr. Fate created into the future. Stripesy was brought back to the future, but into a world he didn't recognize. The remaining members of the Seven Soldiers of Victory had all either died, disappeared, retired, or handed down their mantles. Stripesy effectively retired and had a kid with a woman named Maggie Shaw, and the couple had a young boy named Michael. Pat, facing another hardship, also had all of his patents for his gadgets stolen by Sylvester Pemberton's distant relative, Arthur. Sylvester was able to help get these patents back for him, and for a brief period of time, Pat acted as a member of Infinity Inc., Sylvester's superhero team he founded as a home for superheroes who were essentially rejected from joining the JSA. Sylvester is unfortunately killed during a battle with the Injustice Society. At this point, the Injustice League focuses their attack on Pat, but fails when team member Hazard has a change of heart due to Pat's young child, Michael. Maggie then leaves Pat to raise Michael on her own. From here, Pat is sort of softly reintroduced into the DC universe. He shows up in Stars and Stripes, where he's remarried to a woman named Barbara Whitmore, and along with their daughter Courtney, moves from LA to Blue Valley, Nebraska. One day, when looking through his things, she finds Pat's old costume and a number of relics from his career with Sylvester and the Seven Soldiers. She steals the original Star Spangled Kid uniform and the cosmic converter belt that Pat had also left in his possession, and she becomes the new Star Spangled Kid. For more of her origin and reasoning for this, check out our video on Stargirl, of course. However, Pat decides to aid her, mostly because he believes she's too immature to handle the responsibility. But this time, Pat wears a mechanized suit of battle armor codenamed Stripe, or Special Tactics Robotic Integrated Power Enhancer. This armor also has multiple weapons, including missiles, electrical attacks, and a rocket punch, which is exactly what it sounds like and awesome. The majority of Pat's early adventures with Courtney are covered in our Stargirl Origins Explained video, so feel free to check that out, but keep in mind that he kind of plays the role of a sidekick or a enforcer a bit. Stars and Stripe is really more of the Stargirl show, and he kind of plays the occasional muscle. Courtney pulls away from him in terms of popularity with fans and writers, and he doesn't really show up much after Infinite Crisis. And that is about it for the comic book origins of Pat Dugan, aka Stripesy, aka Stripe. Hopefully you learned a lot, and if you did, consider subscribing and dropping a like on the video. This has been Nick for Key Issues. Thank you again for watching, and remember the motto, Stripe over everything.